Evan, how you doing?
Hey, my name's Evan. Just watching the show, enjoying it. Wondering, do you guys believe in anything agnostic at all? Like any power?
Believe in anything agnostic?
Believe in agnosticism?
That's what I meant. Sorry, okay. It's been a long day.
I have a favorite definition of the difference between atheist and agnostic, if you want to hear that.
I would love to.
Okay. This is from a book called... it'll come to me later. I can't remember. And this is coming from a guy who's an objectivist, which I don't agree with. I'm not an Ayn Rand objectivist type. But he made, a very useful distinction between atheists and agnostics. Okay? Atheism and theism are terms to describe what somebody believes, right? An atheist doesn't believe in a god, and a theist does believe in a god. Gnosticism and agnosticism are about what you know, okay?
Right.
An agnostic is somebody who at least says that they don't know if there's a god or not. And a Gnostic is someone who says that they know that there's a god.
Right.
Right. Or that they know there isn't. I guess you could have a Gnostic theist who claims that they know for sure.
Right.
That means that it's not as normally, as people normally consider it, like theists, agnostics, atheists, right? Three different levels of belief about the same thing. There's four kinds. There's Gnostic theists who believe and claim to know. There's agnostic theists. And there's a lot of these in my experience. These
Most are people would claim to be.
People who believe but admit that they don't actually know. Then there's Gnostic atheists, as I just discussed, and agnostic atheists who say, I don't actually know, but I don't believe.
Right.
See? That to me sorts it all... Huh?
I said I might be under that category then, I guess. I'm just trying to figure things out here.
Okay.
Yeah. Most people fall into the agnostic category. Most of the religious people, they admit that they don't know for a fact. They can't prove God exists, but they choose to believe. I can't prove God doesn't exist. I don't know it for a fact.
So are you guys more into the scientific aspect? Is that what causes your beliefs on atheism? Like, is it science or
lack of belief?
Lack of belief. Yeah, I'm sorry.
I would say reason rather than science. Because reason is just a specific...
Okay.
Science is just a specific application of, you know, rational thinking.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now, we haven't seen any good, solid evidence out there that a big supernatural universe-creating entity exists. Therefore, no reason.
So you wouldn't believe in reincarnation or anything like that? You basically just have a lot.
Again, don't see the evidence.
Haven't seen any evidence?
Yeah, exactly.
Can I make this even more complicated for you?
I'd love to.
I also don't like to, you know, once I've gone from three labels to four labels because I think that's clearer. But I also don't like to just pick one of those labels and say that's what I am.
Right.
Because say I was to visit some South Seas island, and I meet the islanders, and they take me to their village, and they've got a totem pole, and they say that's their god. I see it right there. I can go up and rap on it with my knuckles. That god exists. Right? Now, if they start telling me he makes the rains come, I probably will disagree about what his actual superpowers are. But as far as that god is concerned, I am a Gnostic theist. I know for a fact that god exists.
It's right.
So I reserve the term to the particular god we're talking about. Right?
Right.
And what I find is that, you know, a lot of Christians, I think it's pretty easy to disprove the Christian God, if you go specifically by what's literally written in the Bible, right? There's this great thing called the problem of evil that makes it logically impossible for the Christian God to exist.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll go into that some other time. But but a lot of Christians then just start backing away like mad, like that previous caller was doing, I think.
Right.
Backing away from what the Bible actually says and turning their God into some amorphous, magical something or other that exists in the universe that you can't put your finger on.
Right.
That doesn't really do anything for certain that you can know, and making it impossible to know anything about it, right?
Right.
So that all you can be is an agnostic. But I'm an agnostic atheist when it comes to that God, because I still don't believe in it. Why should I?
Right, that's it. Okay.
Okay.
Well, thank you, man.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Have a good one, you guys.
You too.
Tim.
The content of this video is produced by the Atheist Community of Austin, a nonprofit educational organization promoting positive atheism and the separation of church and state. If you enjoyed this content and are willing and able to provide a donation, please visit the website below.